Hi, good morning, my dear student. Previously we discussed about the chemistry of lipid. Now we discuss about the lipid metabolism. The before going to the lipid metabolism, we are thorough about in the previous class the chemistry and what are the lipids. Now it will be metabolized in our body and how it will be metabolized. We will discuss today. Myself, Mr. Deepak Kumar Singh, Assistant Professor of Calcutta Institute of Pharmaceutical Technology and Allied Health Sciences. So, first of all, in these situations, we convey my message: stay home, safe life, to prevent the COVID-19. This is the burning situation in this country. If you prevent this, to all of you, I earn a request to stay at your home. Now we start the lipid metabolism. First of all, various topic discuss of lipid metabolism. First, how to digestion of the lipid, absorption of lipid, and what is chylomicron, beta oxidation of fatty acid, oxidation of odd chain fatty acid, alpha oxidation, omega oxidation, de novo synthesis of fatty acids, synthesis of triglycerols and metabolism of adipose tissues, fatty liver and lipotropic factors, ketogenesis and ketolysis. First, digestion of lipid. How to digestion of lipid? The major dietary lipids are triglycerol, cholesterol and phospholipids, which is obtained from the diet. And the average normal diet, Indian diet, contain about 20 to 30 gram of lipid per day. But in case of European country, they are 2 to 3 times of this day. The basically the diet source is contain the fatty acid, triglycerol, and ultimately all are converted into a fatty acid after digestive enzymes. The first is digestion in the stomach. First, the lingual lipase from the mouth enter the stomach along with foods, and it is optimum pH 2.5 to 5. The enzymes therefore continue to active in the stomach. It is acted the short chain fatty acid, and this short chain prevents the milk, butter and ghee. In addition, in the lingual pH observed to the more significant in the newborn infants, and gastric lipase which is present in the stomach, and the optimum pH 5.4. And this will be digested, all the lipid content by the lipase by this pH. Another is the most important, the digestion in the stomach. When the food enter into the stomach, it formation of a chyme. This chyme is digested in the intestine by the process of emulsification. The emulsion is the prerequisite for the digestion of the lipid, because lipid is the oily substances which are not solubilized in the water, but our body is only substances can be digested by the water soluble. So how to solubilize? Basically it is solubilized with water, with lipid by emulsification process. And in this case, there is just in the small intestine, there is the three process involved in the emulsification. First of all, the bile salt, which is acts as a detergent, just like a detergent to reduce the surface tension. Another is the peristalsis, that is the mechanical mixing. That means the mechanical process by which the bigger particle can be in a smaller particle, and the surface will be increases, and it will be absorbed. Another is the phospholipid, which is all the phospholipid compound which contain the hydrophobic tail and hydrophobic head food. They are mixed up with the lipids and they are solubilized to form a micellar formation. Ultimately, all are digested in the intestine. And bile salt is the another important for the digestion of the lipid. The bile salt present in the stomach, it are two type of bile salt, sodium glycosylate and sodium taurocholate, which is lower the surface tension, and they emulsify the fat droplets. ultimately increase the surface tension of the particles for enhance the activity of the enzymes, and ultimately the digestion helped by the bile salts. And the lipolytic enzyme which is present in the intestine, the pancreatic lipase, cholesterol esterase and phospholipase A2. The basically the pancreatic lipase which is digest the lipid in the small intestine, and the, by the pH 7.7, and all these compound goes to the small intestine, the larger surface area muscle intestine, it will be absorbed the bloodstream, then it will be goes to the cell for digestion. So many lipase which are involved for the digestion of lipids, but how to regulation of the lipase? It is a very sensitive, hormone sensitive enzymes is controlled by the lipase. The basically enzyme, these are two types of lipase. One is the inactive or TG, that means triglyceride lipase B or inactive form, and there is a hormone sensitive triglyceride lipase A. This is the active form. Basically this active form of triglyceride which is digest the triglyceride, first of all it is the diacylglycerol and one fatty acid, then another monoacylglycerol, then glycerol. But this lipase which is active form by the enzyme of protein kinase, and which is inactive in the presence of phosphatase in the form of TG lipase. This activation is depend basically the protein kinase, and ATP is converted to ADP. This protein kinase which is active or influenced by the cyclic AMP. That cyclic AMP which is coming from the ATP by the presence of adenyl cyclase which is present in the cytosol. But this adenyl cyclase which is regulated by the so many hormones, epinephrine, norepinephrine, glucagon, thyroxine, glucocorticoid, TCH, ACTH and the GH, which is influence the adenyl cyclase, insulin, niacin and PGE1 which is inhibit the action of adenyl cyclase, ultimately to cycling AMP decrease, ultimately protein kinase will be decreased. That's why the lipase activity will be decreased. Another cyclic AMP will be increased in the presence of insulin, basically by the enzyme phosphodiesterase, and caffeine will decrease it. That means in caffeine can produce the lipolysis, and insulin can increase the lipolysis. So many lipase which is act on the different area of the stomach, mouth, stomach, one fatty acid with diacylglycerol, small intestine, fatty acid with two monoacylglycerol, small intestine, three fatty acid and glycerol, and small intestine, capillary walls, ultimately all are converted into a different fatty acid and glycerol. Then we start the how to metabolize the glycerol and the fatty acid. We see the chart. How to absorb? The very good, the long chain fatty acid can be absorbed. Long chain means there are more than 14 carbon atoms. There are more limbs and not directly by the blood. Therefore, this process is the gastrum. We see the pictures, the fats with bile salt, their form, and finally the smaller particle which is absorbed by the small intestine, and absorption of the lipid by the mix of the micelle formation which is discussed in the earlier, and chylomicron which is the another compound or lipoprotein or VLDL which is transport the lipid, it bind with the lipids and to form in the small intestine as well as from the liver, they transport the lipid into the adipose tissue. And these are the structure how to bind with the bile salt and the long chain fatty acid and in the chylomicron, the triglyceride, and ultimately they goes to the blood vessels. A complete hydrolysis of the triglyceride. The first, the triglyceride or the lipid, which is first enzyme lipase, which contains 2-3 diacylglycerol. After the lipase, 2 monodiacylglycerol and isomerase, 1 monoacylglycerol. And finally the lipase, ultimately glycerol and fatty acid. That means after the ingestion of fats or oil, it will be ultimately converted into a fats, free fatty acid plus glycerol. So how to metabolize the glycerol? This is a summary of utilization of fats. Beta oxidation of fatty acid. First step of this is the process beta oxidation, because the oxidation and splitting of two carbon occurs in the beta carbon atoms. The oxidation of hydrocarbon chain occurs by the sequential cleavage of two carbon atoms. Preparative steps of beta oxidation. This is the coenzyme A, which is the complex molecules, B complex vitamin, pentathemic acid, and molecule of beta mercaptoethanol. Is this SH group from thioester bond is acyl CoA. This emphasizes the function of SH group, and the CoA is something written by the COASH. The first step is the activation of fatty acids. In this case, the thiokinase, which is basically cleaves the bone, the fatty acid, basically the long chain fatty acid and the small chain, medium chain fatty acid. First, the fatty acid in the presence of thiokinase, it converted to acyl adenylate, and 2 ATP will be utilized in the first step of reaction. After that, acyl adenylate is converted to acyl CoA. Then steps to role of carnitine. This is the another step, because these are the another important steps. This acyl CoA never enter into the mitochondrial membrane, because the beta oxidation which is occurred in the mitochondria, but acyl CoA do not enter into the mitochondrial membrane. That's why there is some another shuttle or transport system by the carnitine to help the acyl CoA outer mitochondrial membrane to inner mitochondrial membrane. And there is two enzymes are involved in this CAT1, carnitine acyl transferase 1 and carnitine acyl transferase 2, to convey the acyl CoA outer mitochondrial membrane to inner mitochondrial membrane for beta oxidation. Then carnitine shuttle transferase, and the another is the translocate, to translocate the acyl CoA into the mitochondria. There is some clinical application. The medium and short chain fatty acid do not requires carnitine transport across. It is directly across the mitochondrial membrane. So the medium chain and short chain fatty acid can easily oxidize. But if in case of long chain fatty acid, if the carnitine is deficiency is reported in case of preterm infants in whom impaired fatty acid oxidation is noticed. So more glucose is utilized, resulting in the episodes of the hypoglycemia, because excess glucose is utilized due to carnitine deficiency and produce a deficiency of glucose, that is called hypoglycemia. And number 3, deficiency of translocate, it leads to to defects metabolism of long chain fatty acid. In this condition, the muscle cramp are precipitated by the fasting, exercise and high fat diet. These are the process by which the beta oxidation is occurs. In this process, we can see the first is the activation process after the minor mitochondria, outer mitochondria to inner mitochondrial membrane, and there is a 4 step of reaction. First, the acyl CoA in the presence of acyl CoA dehydrogenase FAD to FADH2 is converted into a beta transenoyl CoA. This transenoyl CoA hydrolyze, which is converted to beta hydroxy fatty CoA. Then another is a beta hydroxy fatty acyl dehydrogenase or dehydrogenase reaction, beta ketoacyl CoA. Then the 4th step of reaction, the thiolase, which is depend on the chain length of this acyl CoA, it converted to 1 acetyl CoA, another fatty acid. The next fatty acid which undergoes the next beta oxidation. The first of all, we see that the 1 acyl CoA, which is 1 beta oxidation, it is converted into acetyl CoA. That means 2 carbon chain will be left, and another carbon chain of fatty acid, which is next, undergo the beta oxidation. So actually beta oxidase in the fourth reaction are sequential repeat for the complete oxidation of fatty acid. After one round and four metabolic steps, one acetyl CoA until split of an acyl CoA within two carbon atom less is generated. With woods undergo the same series of reaction again until the fatty acid is completely oxidized. The FAD linked dehydrogenase. First, dehydrogenase reaction, which is already discussed here, and hydration. Number 3, NAD dependent dehydrogenation, and finally the cleavage. For the energy calculation of this molecule, suppose in case of palmitic acid, there is a 16 carbon atom containing fatty acid, which is beta oxidation. As per picture, you can see the beta oxidation, the 7 cycle occurs, and in case of 7 cycle, 14 ATP and another 3 ATP, and in case of acetyl CoA, 8 acetyl CoA, 8 into 12 equal to 96, total 131, and in case of activation minus 2, so ultimately we gain 119 in actual practice in previous. But now this formula is totally wrong. It's nowadays generally we are previously talking about the FADH2 produce 1.5 molecules of ATP and NADH produce 2.5, and previously we told NADH produce 3 ATP. But nowadays when the oxidized transport electron, hence the energy yield in this molecule, it is quite different. In that case, we can the net yield of fatty acid 108 and minus 1 106 in case of previous reported in 129. That there are just two example you can confuse, because there's two structure given from the two books. That's why the first one, it is the 2F6FAD and 6NAD and 2H2, ultimately 6-acetyl-CoA-FADH2 and 7-step reaction of beta oxidation and 8-acetyl-CoA. Ultimately, we get 129 ATP. Regulation of beta oxidation. Every oxidation, every process which is regulation, otherwise it will be a problem. The first, the availability of free acid. If the free fatty acid is present, is regulated net utilization through the beta oxidation. Number 2, the level of free fatty acid is turned into the control by the glucagon is to insulin ratio. Glucagon increase the free fatty acid level, and insulin has the opposite effect, that means reduce the free fatty acid level. CAT1 is the regulator for entry of the fatty acid into the mitochondrial, but it is inhibited by the mannoyl CoA inhibitors. Thus, the de novo synthesis of fatty acid and beta oxidation is inhibited. Defect of beta oxidation. A abnormality in transport of fatty acid into the mitochondria and defects in the oxidation can be lead to deficient energy production by oxidation of long chain fatty acid, and common feature of hypoenergic hypoglycemia, hyperammonemia, skeletal muscle weakness, and liver disease. Acyl carnitine accumulation owing to the transferage or translocase is deficiency. Dietary supplement of carnitine has to be found to improve the symptoms in some cases. Oxidation of odd chain fatty acid. In earlier we are see the even number of fatty acid, but in case of odd chain fatty acid, there is some different, but very little bit of different. There is a huge difference. There is some difference in the odd chain acid are oxidized exactly in the same manner as even chain fatty acid. However, after successive removal of two carbon units at the end, the 1-3 carbon unit or propionyl CoA is produced. That is the difference. Otherwise, everything is same. But how it will be formed? There generally 5 step of another reaction: carboxylase, racemate and mutage, and succinyl CoA and propionyl CoA. These are the steps. The propionyl CoA is called formation of dimethyl manonyl CoA, and the racemate it called L-methyl manonyl CoA, and finally desuccinyl CoA. The succinyl CoA goes into the TCA cycle. If it is the deficiency, it is the vitamin B12 deficiency, the methyl malonic acid is formed. otherwise the energy will be less in case of odd number of fatty acid, otherwise it will be the same process extra, it will be only the propionyl CoA metabolism. So we can see the odd number and even number fatty acid how to oxidize by the beta oxidation. We discuss details. Next class we discuss about the ketogenesis and other things. Thank you all my students for patience. Thank you again all of you.